The reason you don't have the life that you want yet is pretty simple. It could be complex, but I'm going to try to simplify it really quick. This is just some thoughts that I've been having recently from experiences from my own life, and I'm hoping that sharing this with you today can help spark some motivation or even some insight on your own life to improve. The main thing that I want to bring up today is minimalism, which has a tendency to seem like the most extreme, absurd thing ever. The idea is pretty simple. Live minimally. Don't have more than you need. But a lot of times the imagination can just imagine that these people just live in a box and a chair and maybe a bed, I guess, sometimes. But hear me out on this one, because I think minimalism as a principle can really help fix your life in a lot of different ways if you apply it in the correct way. And with minimalism, I think it's important to remember that the principle and the idea of that philosophy is that you are trying to minimize the inefficient things in your life, specifically like objects and things that you own, or maybe expenses, for instance. But I think the principle that applies here is to your life, and not just physical objects, but also to things in your life that are not helping you achieve your goals. So I don't want to talk about just physical declutter. That's something I'm working on, obviously. You can tell I have way too much stuff. But I want to talk about the mental decluttering and activity decluttering that you can do in your own life to achieve more of your goals in life. Minimalism, as defined online, is, quote, focuses on embracing quality over quantity. Minimalists are thoughtful in their selection of items, ensuring everything owned serves a purpose and enhances their experience. It's also defined as, I quote, intentionally living with the fewer possessions, focusing on the one that you need. So in our lives, there's lots of different things that can distract us, and without us even realizing it, 365 days goes by, as we've all experienced recently as of me posting this video. It just goes by so quickly, and we realize we have not achieved maybe hardly anything, honestly. And that's how I've come to feel every single year. Setting goals and not really achieving them doesn't really leave you with a good taste in your mouth. So in order to help us to achieve those goals, the idea of this minimalism is applying it so that way we can actually have your goals come to fruition. So this is going to involve some weeding out of your life. So imagine your life is like a roadmap. You want to get from usually point A to point B. But life isn't really that simple. There are a ton of obligations in life, and many times you can find yourself having all of these different pit stops that really sometimes are important, and a lot of them sometimes can just be weeded out because they're not really that important. Some of those pit stops can be responsibilities with family, friends, just general responsible things that you have to do in life, but some of them are not actually necessary, even though we feel like they are necessary. In today's culture, it's very common to feel like you have to be super productive, or you have to have all of these things going on in your life and your schedule to make you feel happy or content in life, but that's just not the case. I think it's selecting the few right things, like minimalists with their objects, that help you achieve your goal and make you feel stable and happy. Those are the things you should be focusing on. And it might just be one thing a day that you do that helps you to achieve that goal and gives you the content that you want to feel. And a lot of these pit stops, like I talked about, maybe are things that aren't exactly negative. Some of them can be bad habits. Some of them can be just things that are absurdly wrong in life and you just need to either stop doing them or find some other good thing to replace them with. But a lot of these things can be weeded out, such as like maybe coming home and watching a TV show to unwind and decompress from a stressful day. That is something that I do a lot, like every single day, even when I'm not really that stressed. But there comes a point where its usefulness starts to decline after so much time, right? You only need so much time to decompress, and after a while, you're just kind of starting to get into the territory of being lazy and not really doing much with your life at that point, right? You're wasting time. So you kind of have to figure out the balance between what is a necessary entertainment, fun thing to do that will help me and keep me going versus do I have enough? Am I full on entertainment and having free time? And now I need to start working on some actual goals. And I think that's something that I am trying to constantly work on in my life. But with the idea of minimalism, it just kind of blew my mind once it kind of clicked. And I just feel like it's something that's just so obvious, but not at the same time. So concisely, being a minimalist in this philosophical principle of trying to achieve goals and make your life happier, more fulfilling, is trying to weed out all of the things that aren't serving you, that aren't serving that bigger purpose. And it's not just for your goals, but, you know, just moral principles and values you have in your life. If there's something in your life that's not serving you, it's harming you. And you don't have to be an object that life goes through. You are an active person who chooses the life that you want to have. And life is not just happening to you, although some things do happen to you that you can't control. But for the most part, you can use your agency in a lot of different ways. I also want to mention that we have like a set amount of energy and time during the day. And if some activity or something that you're doing is not helping you achieve your goal, then you should weed it out because it's wasting that energy that could be spent somewhere else, if that makes sense. So just as much as you might budget your finances, I think budgeting your energy and time every day, every week, every month, whatever feels right to plan out for you is highly, highly necessary in order to obtain the things that you want to obtain, because a lot of our goals are pretty haughty and high, right? For me, I have this YouTube channel that I hope to grow and get monetized on pretty soon. And I also have a wedding and videography for photography business that I am running and growing right now currently. And so there's a lot on the line. There's a lot to do, which can feel overwhelming. But I think if you take it day by day, you can piece it out and it doesn't feel as daunting. And I also want to add another quote, which comes from the Bible. It's in John chapter 15, verse 2. Every branch in me that beareth not fruit, he taketh away. And every branch that beareth fruit, he purgeth it, that it might bring forth more fruit. So purge is meaning like purify, right? You don't have to be too religious to understand the principle that is being spoken about here. If there is something that's not serving you, something that's not giving you fruit, as this parable is talking about as a tree, then you should probably cut off those branches that aren't serving the grander tree any purpose. If it doesn't bear fruit, why should you have the branch be taking energy and supply from the ground and from the tree if it's not producing any fruit? So just get rid of it. Same thing in life. If there's something that's not serving you, that is just a waste of time, you should probably consider figuring out how to weed it out. And like I've mentioned before, with starting my own photography, videography business for weddings and other such things, I have learned a lot doing that. And I feel like some of these principles were things that I was kind of following all along without realizing it. Again, I'm not very perfect at this, but I feel like pushing towards my goals, posting more on my photography account has helped a lot, and just making certain things a priority where otherwise I might just waste time or just say, I'll do it tomorrow, and that will never ever happen if I say that. And honestly, it just keeps snowballing from there, so trust me on that one. This is something that we're always going to be working on. It's not just like a one-time event. It's something that we have to continually try to figure out and reevaluate what we're doing versus what we want, and making sure that the balance is not too heavy on the side of things that we don't want that we're doing. We have to make sure that we have more choices that are leading towards the things that we want rather than the things that will lead us away. So it's kind of a simple idea, but I think putting it in terms like this has definitely helped me a lot as I was researching and writing this video. So I hope you can find and identify the things in your life that are not leading you to where you want to be, and that you can weed those out. Those could be distractions, those could be things that aren't necessarily bad, but just things that aren't really helping out in the long term, right? And I hope that this idea helps motivate you if you haven't started to work towards your goals this year. And if you already are working on your goals, I hope it helps you even more, and that you can be even more successful than you already have been. And again, if you have any tips or suggestions, I really welcome it in the comment section. Let's have a discussion there and share what we've experienced in our own lives, because the internet is full of people that are just amazing and wise and very successful. So if you are one of those people watching this video, thank you so much for watching, and I will catch you guys in the next one. Peace.